Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, Rudy here with your yard service, and another beautiful day in the woodyard. Days on end, but today we have a little bit of a disaster to talk about. And as you can see, wood is supposed to be stacked and stay on in row, but you see here, what is this, Rudy? This is toppled third of a cord or face cord of aspen and poplar. Just fell over about a couple of days ago. Was beautifully stacked like the other one. So I'm thinking, rather than keeping it on the ground, or ideally to be restacked. Well, not ideally. So ideally, I want to sell it as quick as possible. So I made a post on Facebook Marketplace, special pricing, because just needs to get off the ground, and rather than me kind of stacking it up again, I'd rather get rid of it and make someone happy and warm. Sorry about this cough here. Anyways, so this is kind of like the things that happen when you have firewood sitting a little bit too long in your wood yard, because as the stacks dry out, they settle and shift, and then you end up with this kind of scenario. This is real life. The struggle is real, as they say. Well, it's a challenge, but all challenges can be overcome. But other news, and much better news in the woodyard, besides the solar stove going strong again, well, somewhat strong, because I just started it. Here in the truck, we have some beautiful spruce logs. These guys are like 14 inches rounds. And look at this. Look at this beauty. Look at those guys. Nice, eh? Nice. So, I already started diving into those guys with starting to split them up. Oh yeah. So, rather than dropping them on the ground and waiting on the splitting part, why not carry them over? Because like it's like the ideal height for picking them up, carry height, rather than dropping them on the ground, stacking them, and then picking them up again later for splitting, which like the hard part, like picking them off the ground, because those suckers are pretty heavy. So this is like perfect pickup height, carrying them over to the Wallenstein splitter. So just before I was diving into those hardwood rounds here, before I picked up those spruce logs, the story how that came about is I'm going to share in a second. So I was splitting those hardwood rounds, and then I came about those spruce logs. So I'm kind of like making a slight adjustment in schedule. So Facebook Marketplace can be a nice place if you're quick enough. So I saw this ad about spruce logs being cut down and being like sitting at curbside for free pickup, free. And the ad said like, well, it was a whole bunch from the pictures, like it didn't really say how many, but like quite a few would have been a nice load. I say like would have been. So like ad said like 2 to 4 feet length. I think a little bit smaller than those guys. Anyways, I saw that late night, said, okay, I'm gonna wake up early next day to take a look at it in the city and hopefully to still find them there. I wouldn't expect anyone to come throughout the night picking them up because you would have needed to cut them down in order to lift them up in the truck because like wet wood, fairly heavy. Anyways, so I got up early in my terms, or early enough in order to make a fuss in the neighborhood. When I got there, it was already gone. What a bummer. So I was kind of like still keeping driving down the road. And lo and behold, I saw these guys also sitting at curbside, like different property. I saw them sitting at the curbside. I was kind of like, what the heck? They need to be picked up rather than wasted sitting here in the snow and on the ground. And yeah, so I just stopped. Curbside means free. So I did that. Obviously, I had to cut them up because like those 14-inch rounds are like still heavy. So they are like about like probably like 4 feet length. So this is what I got. And I think it's a good score. Maybe not the most I would have gotten out of the other one. Well, as much as out of the other, like the real advertisement on Facebook. But still good enough to make the trip worthwhile. So I'm gonna get to those guys right now, and well, I can actually tell you how nice of a firewood it gives you, because I I cheated on you guys and started already. So this is like the bark free stuff, which kind of goes up into my premium firewood for bagging. And you can see, those are like beautiful pieces. Mostly straight. There's some wavy stuffs. Like this is a little bit wavy, but like still straight. And yeah, obviously it looks really fresh because it was just split. So this stuff here is already somewhat seasoned. So I tried to cut the knots out when I bucked them up, so to get the most straight and nice quality out of those guys. So I know I've been boring you with quite a few of spruce log splitting sessions already. But I think this is like some of the better quality logs I've sitting around for now. So why not dive into them and enjoy the split? So let me just explain what I'm trying to do when we when I have a log that is rather knotty, and how to still make the most out of it without messing things up too badly, or like trying to maximize the output in premium firewood like as straight as possible and without any jumble messes in that piece. So let me swing you around. So this is like pretty much the perfect stick for our, well, in general for like firewood. Nice and straight grain, no bark. It's a middle piece, so only a little branch here like that. So this is like the pretty close to ideal what I want to get out of it. This one here is nice, but as you can see, has this pretty big flow in a wavy curve here, which was like formed around a knot or branch. So this is not, it's still a nice piece, but it's not ideal for our bagging. So this goes into our bulk firewood over there. So here I'm gonna point out some pieces that have big knots here. And obviously it goes like deeper than just like on the surface. So as you can see, it kind of like bulges out there here. So this is like when I have the log sitting in the splitter here, I try to locate the knot and then basically run the knife right on the right on the outside edges of that knot, expecting the knot will go kind of like, I'm trying to predict which way the knot will run in the log. Ideally to keep the knot straight and then split perpendicular to that or along that knotty line there, hoping I will just graze the knot and get splits on the left and right side that are nice. So here, kind of like somewhat successful. That little sliver here we can pull off like this. So, but this, as you can see, compared to this guy here, this is rather a big chunk. But I'd say it's still good for like the bulk firewood. And here, same with this guy here. This like a smaller knot than this guy here. Same idea. Basically run the knife on either side of the knot. And then you end up with this guy. So the challenge is predicting how deep this way the knot will run, because you'd like, if it gets too big, you're basically trying to get another split out of it. But with this big of a knot, you can expect this will run pretty deep. So if I would attempt to cut another split like this way, are probably gonna run into that knot here, and that's where you can expect getting a mess out of this piece here further away, because the knot basically interrupts the splitting line. So in this case, I rather leave a big piece and decide to go it for bulk rather than messing up the whole piece and then having junk. So that's a challenge there. Then you can get like flowy pieces like this, which is still nice. They're like, so this would be kind of like sitting on either side here. This is actually like a think this came, this was one piece. So as you can see, I want to get another piece out of this big chunk here. So I ran the splitter across here and I got this guy out of it, which is nice. Has a little flow to it, but like it's a smaller piece, nice to handle. And we made this one more handable as well, because would have been pretty much like close to double the size. So this is the challenge of the splitting for knotty pieces. I hope this helps distinguishing what kind of like thought process goes into the splitting entirely when you have pieces that are not ideal. So trying to maximize your outcome of nice straight grain pieces that you can sell or that are not a struggle to handle when you want to have a nice fire and that are not too big and not too much of a jumble mess. Hope that helps. And that's a wrap. We have accomplished quite a bit. So you see, all those nice spruce logs are gone. These have to be bucked up because when I pulled up to that site, I was very ambitious and grabbed those in one piece. These two here, so I'll have to buck them up. Not today. But all the bucked up rounds are not on the solar stove, but these are the last two wheelbarrows, and they're going to be stacked over there. Beautiful barkless premium firewood for our bags, and this is like also premium firewood but with bark, so that's the only difference, plus a few more chunky pieces in there. So yeah, and I would say this splitter is pretty awesome. The only thing I would like to have is like a log lift for sure. And then coming up next, we will resume those logs over there, which like my hardwood mix. So some of that stuff is already a little bit punky. I try to split this off and chuck it into the solar stove and keep the non-punky stuff for our firewood sales. So there you have it, guys. Rudy here with your yard service out of the wood yard, coming to you on a beautiful mid-December mild afternoon. Hit the thumbs up, like, subscribe, you know what to do, and I will talk to you next time. Over and out, Rudy here.